Welcome to this video lecture of workability, segregation and bleeding. I am discussing this property during concrete chain because they are some properties which affect the concrete chain or concrete production series. That is why I am discussing this property at the time when I was discussing about the concrete production or concrete chain. The first property which I am discussing here is workability. It is the property of freshly mixed concrete which determine the ease and homogeneity with which it can be mixed, placed, consolidated and finished. It is a property which directly impact the strength, quality, appearance and even the cost of labor for placement and finishing operations. There are different expectations and agenda across the spectrum of design or construction team when it comes to the optimum concrete design. The structure engineer, he wants the structure with high strength and a good bond with reinforcing steel. The architect is concerned about cosmetic appearance or cosmetic operations. Bearing capacity is attractive to the owner because it allows smaller cross-section of structural elements and therefore he can use the floor space at its maximum. Now, what about the labor? A labor needs a mix which he can transport or which can be moved easily, which can be placed easily, which can be consolidated efficiently and easily. And the mason who is finishing the concrete, he is looking for something that takes that may give durability, high quality finish very quickly and very easily. So a concrete mix with good workability bring so many attributes together and in balance result a quality product with long service life. So this workability has got different definition with different domain people. Even in civil engineering also, we got confused about workability and consistency. We got confused that is there any difference between consistency of the concrete and workability of the concrete. Now, the factors which affect the workability is as follows. It can be considered in a point that proportion and characteristic of the material. Now, in what proportion you have taken and what is the characteristic, what, how does the aggregate is behaving, which company's cement you have taken, what about the fine aggregate, it is well graded, uniformly graded, poorly graded, what are those characteristics? So it can affect the workability of the concrete or mixed design because if in mixed design we go for higher strength mixed design such as M60, M80, at that condition the water cement ratio is calculated and very less. So obviously the workability will be going to be less. Now we have to design such that, or we have to add some material so that at that strength also the workability will be good. Now third point is water cement ratio. Higher proportion of cement or cementitious material usually means greater strength, and with proper amount of water more paste is coating the surface of aggregate for easier consolidation and for better finish. Not enough water for proper hydration is available, then it means that the concrete will achieve the poor strength, or there is a poor strength development and an uncooperative mix which decrease the workability, which can decrease the workability. So at that time the mason or labor or engineer, he want to mix the water to make it more workable or to make it more lubricant, but adding water can affect on the strength. The adding excessive water can increase the workability because it make it easier to place and consolidate, to compact, but it may have negative impact on segregation, finishing operations, on final strength. It can be detrimental. So this approach should be used very cautiously. Water to cement ratio of 0.45 to 0.6 is a sweet spot, but above it or lesser than it, both are detrimental. Now next is aggregate stage and shape. As aggregate surface area increases, more cement paste is required to cover the entire surface of the aggregates. So mixed with smaller aggregate are less workable compared to larger size aggregate. But there is a codal provision that you cannot increase the size of aggregate without considering the size of the member at which concrete has to be placed. Now I am talking about shape of the aggregate: elongated, angular, flaky aggregates. They are difficult to mix and to place. They have a greater surface area to cover, which decrease the workability. Rounded aggregates have a lower surface area, but they lack the angularity so that sufficient bond strength is developed with the cement paste. Crushed aggregate with the proper product proportions may provide a better bond with the cement matrix and adequate workability. The last one is admixtures. Now many type of admixture are available in the market, and they alter the workability of fresh concrete, either by design or as a side effect. So surfactants such as super plasticizers, they reduce the attraction between cement and aggregate particles, allowing the mixtures that can be flowable, that which can flow without any negative strength and segregation effect. Even air entraining admixture for fridge and thaw durability properties, they produce air bubbles, and those air bubbles are within a controlled size, which make for easier finishing. But although using too much admixture may produce a sticky mix, and if it is a sticky mix, then the effect will be just opposite to what you want to achieve. Now, how we measure the workability? Some code, they say that is by using slum test also we can measure. So there are several tests about which we discuss in the laboratory. So the tests which are used to simulate or to find the workability is slump test, compaction factor test, flow test, Kelly ball test, VB consistometer test. All those methods, they measure some parameters which are used to find out the workability. But there is no such method who can quantify the workability. It can only measure the parameters which are affected by workability. Segregation in concrete is a case of particle segregation in concrete application. This is another problem during concrete transportation or during concrete production, even during placing. In this, particulate solid tend to segregate by virtue of difference in the size, density, shape, and other properties of particles of which they are composed. This may also occur during handling and placement of the concrete. Sometimes during compaction, the over vibration or over compaction of concrete can also segregate the concrete, in which cement paste comes to the top and aggregate settles in the bottom. When poorly graded aggregates and excessive water content is used, then they are the major cause of segregation. A badly proportioned mix where sufficient matrix is not available for bonding and contain the aggregates, where aggregates can settle down, then the chance of segregation is more. Even when concrete are placed underwater, then also there are chances of segregation. So when we understand what is segregation, then we have to understand the reason, the cause of segregation. Now, some causes are enlisted here in the present slide, that due to difference in specific gravity of the mixed constituent, or due to difference in the size of aggregate, even improper grading of aggregate also leads to segregation. Improper handling of aggregate. If you are throwing the mortar pan from a height, then also segregation can occur. Bad practices of handling and transporting of concrete, or as I had said, that if the concrete is too much vibrated or too much compacted, improper mixing. Suppose you have done hand mixing and the mixing is not done properly, the mix is not uniform, then also segregation can happen. As I had said, that placing of concrete from a greater height. Suppose you are pouring the concrete in a column or a foam work of column, then there are chances that if you are using a 3 feet shuttering or 3 feet foam work, then the heavier material may settle down and the paste will be on upwards. Or using badly designed mixer, or the mixer which are having blades which are worn out, then this segregation can happen. To prevent this segregation, some rules are there, certain points are there, such as at the time of construction, especially while using transit mixer, care should be taken that the concrete is not poured from a height greater than 1.5 meter. It is the maximum height. Try to minimize this height of pouring. Second point is aggregate should be properly graded so that the segregation can be prevented. To improve the viscosity of concrete, if viscosity is improved, segregation can be minimized or neglected. So to improve this viscosity, air entraining agent such as Rita can be used. In case of mechanical vibrator, care should be given that it should be used for a stipulated time, stipulated period, and if it is internal vibrator or needle vibrator, then the needle should not touch the foam work and the needle should be properly vertical or inclined at 45 degree only. So these are some preventions which can be taken to prevent the segregation, because it is a very big problem. The another problem is of bleeding. Bleeding is also a form of segregation, but in bleeding, the water present in the concrete mix is pushed upward due to the settlement of cement and aggregate. The specific gravity of water is very low. Due to this, water tend to move upward. That is why bleeding ordinarily occur in the wet mix of concrete. The main factor the prime factor for bleeding in concrete is the high dose of water, or you can say high dose of water cement ratio. And this higher water cement ratio make the concrete weak and leads to excessive bleeding. The bleeding in concrete is not harmful till the rate of evaporation of water is equal to rate of bleeding. Till then it is not a problem. But if the rate of bleeding is more than rate of evaporation, then it is a problem. Normal bleeding is quite good, it is quite normal. And even if bleeding is there, then it may enhance the workability of the concrete. Even when the concrete is fully in plastic condition, fresh stage, then bleeding is not harmful. But later, it may be subsidized and compacted. So if we discuss about effect of bleeding, why I had told that bleeding is a problem for the concrete stability, or why, what is the effect of bleeding on concrete stability, then the first thing which comes in our mind is the problem of latence. Actually, when water moves upward at the time of bleeding, sometime with this water, certain amount of cement is also moved along with the water to the concrete surface. Now, when the top surface is worked up with the trowel, then the aggregate goes down and cement paste forms at the top surface with water is called latence in the concrete. And due to formation of this latence, structure may lose its wearing capacity and decreases its life, because certain amount of cement is wasted on the surface, top surface of the concrete. Now, the second problem is, water while moving from bottom to the top, it forms a continuous channel, it forms a pipe-like structure. And due to this channel, concrete becomes permeable. It allows water to move. It will not become that much dense which we had thought of. Now, from this channel, there is a void in the matrix. And if there is a void in the matrix, then the bond between aggregate and cement paste is less, it is decreased. In the same way, forming of water at the top surface of concrete can result in delaying the surface finish. Concrete becomes permeable, then it loses its homogeneity. Even excessive bleeding breaks the bond between reinforcement and the concrete. So, how to prevent it? It can be controlled by adding minimum water contained in the concrete mix. For making it workable, you can add water, but when you are adding water, bleeding can happen. So the water added should be minimum. We can encourage the masons to use air entraining admixture in the mix. And if you see that somehow the water is more in the mix, then only solution is you can add some quantity of cement in the mix, extra quantity of cement. I hope that by using this video lecture, you can avoid the segregation and bleeding in the concrete, and at the same time, the workability can be improved so that the maximum compaction, the best finish can be achieved. Thank you.